Other Boy Reactions.
Hey guys, Other Boy Reactions here. Alright, we are back with The Vampire Diaries, Season 3, Episode 19, Heart of Darkness. If you guys are enjoying my videos, please like, comment, and subscribe. And if you'd like full reactions and early reactions, please check out my Patreon by going to the link down below. Alright, let's get to it.
Damon and I are gonna go to Denver to pick him up.
Of course.
Why do you say that like you're waiting for me to disapprove?
I don't know.
Because he does.
Me and Damon.
Yep.
Traveling across the country.
It's like she wants people to.
I guess I'm more curious here what Stefan has to say about it.
He thinks that I have some unresolved feelings for Damon.
You do.
Honestly, I don't know what my brother sees in you. Maybe he sees a challenge. You see, unlike some other people, I don't sleep with everyone I make eye contact with.
Maybe we can do both decades.
No.
Oh, they're playing? Yes!
And you bought yourself a day.
Thank you.
Thank you.
So you're worried you're gonna have to torture it out of me.
Can't you just compel him? I don't understand.
No matter what I go through, none of that matters if she has feelings for somebody else.
Right. Careful, hey. Who's your friend? Oh my god! Are you serious?
It's Cole.
Oh my god.
He's an original.
Oh fuck! He stopped it? Cole sucks then. Cole sucks.
Kill him?
No.
It'll give us a head start.
How did he stop a bat by an original?
Can't believe Cole was a vampire.
Well, didn't you find it weird that you made a friend so fast? You?
No helping.
Oh my god.
She spent her last day in paradise. Soaking in the sun and reminiscing about what it means to be human.
She's here.
Oh. Which version of her? What she look like? Okay. Is he cured?
You have no idea how much I've missed you.
You gonna do it in here? Do not actually fall for her.
Like I spill. Is that everything my family's done to you?
Mm-hmm.
What are you up to?
It's sad that you can't just get a ride home from school without thinking there's some ulterior motive.
There is. She wants so badly to believe in this.
Goodbye, Matt.
Who is it? Oh, she's back. Oh, shit!
Give me one good reason why I shouldn't kill you right now.
Can you?
Because I'm dying.
She misses you.
And tell him that I'm rooting for him and Elena.
Ugh, I'm not. Oh, God. He didn't know about
she,
that.
She misses both of you.
He's not gonna say it.
Klaus didn't sire me. No original did.
What? Who
it was
did?
Mary Porter.
Who's
she
that?
Was sired by someone named Mary Porter.
He's me.
Yeah, that's in you.
What drives him?
Drives you.
Is me. Is the darkest parts of you. Parts we all have.
So the fate of the entire vampire race depends on you finding a stake. And to get it, we need you to pass out.
Oh shit! Oh!
So we're just stuck in this motel until she gets back to us.
Oh god.
So what's up with you and Damon?
Yeah. Someone knock some sense into her, please.
Nothing's up.
You sure about that?
No one should live that long.
Mm-hmm.
But I haven't lived at all.
Well, whose fault is that?
So I remember.
She's dying, like, right now? What? That's it?
She's dead.
I didn't even get to say goodbye. She left him again! At least they're happy.
Did I mention I miss you? Bad.
I think you just demonstrated that.
All I know is I just turned about 100 times in the Appalachian Mountains.
Oh shit, wow.
If I can get through that, I can get through anything.
Wow.
If he finds out it wasn't Klaus, they're all gonna kill him.
So if he dies, I die.
Mm.
I know that. Damon doesn't care.
Here we go. Oh god, are they sharing a bed?
You never told me about that. What you did for us.
Was it about you?
Okay.
Why don't you let people see the good in you?
Because when people see good, they expect good.
Wow.
And I don't want to have to live up to anyone's expectations.
Oh my god. She just fell in love with him like 10 times more. Oh my god. Of course he comes out. She went outside to get away from you.
don't.
Why not?
Because she's in love with your brother!
Raina.
She's confused. Here we go. No.
Elena?
Yes.
Oh my god, Jeremy,
Yes. Please be pissed at her, please.
Rose found Mary. She lives in Kansas.
Yes, look at her with disappointment and disgust, please. Yes.
God. Wait here.
Why? So you guys can make out some more?
Right, thank you.
Listen to your sister.
No. No, keep being a dick. Why does he need to stay there? Elena can't do shit. Ew. She's been staked? What? Oh, fuck. Oh god, the blood. Oh no.
Give into it.
Fuck.
Try to kill me, Stefan. Come on.
Not like this, Alaric.
Yes! Like this.
Oh, fuck! Jesus. Wow, he controlled it. Fuck. Oh, here he is. Here he is. I thought he was gonna go further.
You're so weak.
Oh, fuck.
And were you her favorite?
You mean, did I turn her? I think I did. But no, wait. Maybe it was Rebecca.
Oh, God.
There was also a class period. And let's not forget the Elijah affair. I spoke to my brother. I know you're trying to find out who you descended from.
Oh! Oh, shit! Oh, fuck. Ooh, that made a mess.
Oh! Oh, dear. I've hit the nerve. Relax, darling. I just want us to be even.
How is he gonna get out of this? Is Elena gonna help?
Now we're even.
Tell me where the stake is before I kill you.
He knows you're not gonna kill
him. You're all gonna burn.
Oh, no!
Kill you in 3, 2, 1.
It's in the cave. Where no vampire can get it.
That makes sense.
What the hell is this?
Stefan thinks that I have feelings for you.
Well, you do! God, well, you wouldn't have kissed him otherwise.
I don't know.
What do you mean you don't know? You just kissed him. You just full-on made out with him. You were about to have sex.
Or maybe you're hoping I'll screw it up so I can just make the decision for you. Am I wrong?
Yes, yes.
Am I wrong?
What you do, Damon.
Right, thank you!
You sabotage things. You sabotage things. You sabotage things. You...
Thank you.
Every time there's a bump in the road, you lash out.
Yes!
What if I didn't? What if there was no bump?
Well, then she'll be with you. But you can't do that.
But this time I'm not going to make it so easy for you. This time you'll have to figure it out for yourself.
Okay.
I've been fighting that part of myself. Thinking that if I repress it, it would go away. And now that I've accepted it, it can't control me. And neither can you. Unless you're gonna stake me.
Get the hell out.
Why don't you get the hell out of my house?
Yeah. Thank you.
You don't see what I see.
God.
It's not just that she makes him a better person. Damon challenges her.
Not in a good
surprises
way.
Surprises her.
Not in a good
he
way.
He makes her question her life.
Not in a good way.
Stefan is different. His love is pure.
Mm-hmm.
He'll always be good for her. Damon is either the best thing for her or the worst.
So get the fuck out. We don't need that. That's Rose's approval. I hate that. They didn't even have a conversation. He didn't even talk to Elena. Mm-hmm. Get jealous, please. Get jealous.
Does Klaus have a thing for you or something?
No.
Yeah.
As far as I'm concerned, he's incapable of real feelings.
Mm-hmm. What the hell happened while I was gone?
Tyler. Nothing happened.
Then why'd you keep this?
I don't know.
Mm-hmm.
Tyler!
You shouldn't have kept it. You kept a memento from the guy who fucked up your boyfriend? I'm just gonna wait.
Now why would I give you...
Right.
...the one thing that requires everyone to keep me alive? There's only one stake out there. Which means only one original has to die.
I don't want one original to die.
What? What?
I want them all to die.
How did you do that?
It was easy to fool Niklaus, but I thought you of all people would understand.
Is that the mother?
You're not Rebecca.
No.
Where is Rebecca?
My name is Esther, and we have a great deal in common.
She just went inside of her? Oh my god. Well, that was a very interesting one. Esther is being smart. So was she lying? Was she not dying, or was she actually dying and she just decided to like transfer herself into Rebecca? Or was she not dying and she just, I don't know. But that's cool. I'm glad we're not rid of Esther, because someone needs to try and take down the originals, even though I know she fails. So the last time we saw Rebecca was when she came home, you know, after Matt dropping her off and she spoke to the mother. Wow. That's cool. Well, we got an even heavier makeout session between Damon and Elena. Not my favorite, of course, but it happened, and I love that Elena had that conversation with him, and she told him what her concerns were, that, you know, it's what he does. What he does is sabotage things, and that would make it easier for her. But I like that he said, you know, this time I'm not going to make it easy on you. So that means he actually cares. But that means he has to compromise. And he said before, you know, earlier, that he doesn't want to compromise because he wants to live by his own rules and he doesn't want to live up to other people's expectations. And when you do good, people expect good. Well, she expects good. So you're going to have to do it for her if you want to be with her. And he, you know, he finally realized that, I guess, and he made his choice. So now she has to make hers. Finally. It's like, I can't believe she's still on the fence. Even though so many commenters have said she knows how she feels about him, she does not know how she feels, otherwise she would have made the decision by now. She just said that she doesn't know how she feels. I mean, she knows that she likes him, but she doesn't feel like she should like him. And also, Stefan is so much better now, and you know, he's basically good Stefan again, and she still has feelings for him, so she loves both of them, but she needs to decide which one she wants more. I don't know. I just don't see how, even if she decides, okay, I want to be with Damon now, Stefan's always going to be around. Like, how can you resist? I don't understand how. And if she gets back with Stefan, Damon's always going to be around, so how can she resist him? It's just, it's so shitty. It's such a shitty situation for her. I mean, because you can't have both. That's not how life works. Like, they are not going to want to share her. I love that Tyler is back and he found out that, you know, Klaus is trying to get with Caroline, trying to charm his way into her affections. She says that it's not working, but she kept that picture. She kept that picture. That means something. And she said, I don't know. Yes, you do know. It's like, it's so frustrating. Like, all the female characters, except for Bonnie, can't resist these dangerous, bad men. It's very frustrating. But at least Tyler knows about it, and he'll be, you know, that'll make him even more against Klaus. You know, even if he hasn't gotten rid of this ire bond altogether, this anger will definitely push him to break that bond even more. I mean, Caroline can say that she doesn't have any feelings for Klaus all she wants, but she kept that picture. Like, you should have thrown it away. You shouldn't have accepted anything from him. I mean, the dress was fine because it's like, it was a cute dress, and it's like, that doesn't have any emotional, you know, attachment to it. It's just, it's a nice gift. But this is clearly, this picture is like, you know, soaked in emotion. It's like there's no reason to keep that except if you feel something. I mean, this is the man who has been terrorizing your friends and family, and he forced your boyfriend to be a vampire. I mean, it's like the more the originals are around, the more everyone just gets used to them. The audience gets used to them, the characters in the show get used to them, and it's like they kind of just accept them, and so they kind of forget that they're bad and that they're hurting people, and that they're not your friends. But it's also because, like, it's like you can't kill them, so they kind of just have to put up with them. I hate that so much. So it makes it easier and easier for guys like Klaus to worm his way in to Caroline's affections. We'll see if she can resist him. I mean, I have a feeling they're at least going to have a kiss or something. And then maybe she'll regret it or something. But it's going to happen, I feel like. I mean, he's 1,000 years old. I'm sure he's perfected, you know, charming people, seducing people. He has to know, like, every trick in the book. So, I mean, I don't know. And if Caroline really doesn't have feelings for him, then she should have ripped up that picture and thrown it away. I loved seeing Stefan control himself in this episode. He finally got control over his bloodlust, and Alaric was the one that helped him do it. Bad Alaric. evil Alaric, as Damon calls him. That was good. I think it was really a moment for Stefan when he realized that he can control himself and he doesn't have to be a slave to blood and his urges. And it also made him realize that he cannot be controlled by Klaus either. That was the only way that Klaus really controlled him. I mean, yes, he controlled him at first because he made him feel like he owed him, and he said, you know, he probably threatened to kill all of, you know, Elena and Stefan's friends if he didn't help him. But after that, he controlled him, you know, because he compelled him to bring out that Ripper part of him. And now Klaus can't do that anymore. At least that's what it seemed like. I mean, I feel like, can't he just, you know, push him against a wall again and compel him to turn it off? Maybe not. Maybe he's completely free of that now. I mean, it was just one time, though. It's just one time that he controlled himself. He needs to do that over and over and over. Just like Tyler needs to, you know, transform over and over and over in order to control himself. So we will have to see how that goes. I didn't care for Rose coming in and basically, I felt like she was gaslighting Jeremy, gaslighting everyone, just making everyone believe that this is okay, that it's okay for Elena to be with Damon. You know, and she's like, you know, you don't see what I see. Because you only see the good part of him. Yeah, of course he has a good part, but he has bad parts too. And most of the time, his bad parts, you know, overtake his good parts. Because he buries his good parts way down deep inside. And he even said he doesn't want to do good because then people will expect good. So, I mean, we'll have to see how long this lasts with Elena before he fucks it up. We will see. And if he can keep it up, then I guess they'll be good together. I just can't see him, even for her, I can't see him being that way for long, though, because he can't help himself. He wants to do what he wants to do, and that is in conflict with doing the right thing, with, you know, with doing good things. Because when all you care about is what you want, eventually other people are going to get hurt, because when you only do what you want, it means you don't care what other people want. So we will have to see. I know he cares about Elena, but she's waiting for him to screw it up, like, once. Like, one time is all it's going to take. At least that's, like, for me. One time. You screw up once, and it's over. Because his history is so checkered. And, like she said, that's what he does. So we will have to see, you know. She still didn't give him an answer. She still didn't make a decision. She'll probably make a decision in the next episode. Well, there's only, like, a few episodes left, so she'll probably make her decision by then, and I'm sure they'll have some, you know, amazing sex scene, and that will confirm her decision. But then how is she gonna still be around Stefan? I just don't understand how that's gonna work. I really don't. I have to admire the writers, because it would have been so easy for her to get with Damon while Stefan was being bad. It would have made sense if she, because that would have made her decision easy. Like, oh, well, like, my boyfriend is evil now, and so I'm gonna choose, you know, the guy who's been here to support me. That would have made her decision so much easier, but she still didn't make a decision then. And now that they're both technically good, it's really hard for her. So that's great. That's great drama. And like Damon said, like, she is not going to be let off the hook. She has to make this decision, which is going to be really hard for her. And that'll be fun to watch. I'm guessing she chooses Damon. I don't know what is going to make her choose him, though. Especially when she still has feelings for Stefan. I don't know. Oh, my goodness. So, were they bringing Jeremy back home to Mystic Falls or back to school? I guess they were bringing him back to Mystic Falls, but he didn't seem, like, too upset. He didn't seem like, I have a lot of friends here, I don't want to leave. So I don't know what's going to happen. But I mean, he's going to be in danger whether he's in Denver or in Mystic Falls, because they didn't do a good enough job hiding him. Klaus can find you anywhere. So I don't know what they're going to do. Do they pull him away from this new life that he seems to be thriving in? Or do they bring him back home and he's back to, you know, probably being depressed again? And in danger, even more immediate danger. I don't know. We'll have to see. But I enjoyed this episode. If you guys did too, please like, comment, and subscribe. And if you'd like full reactions and early reactions, please check out my Patreon by going to the link down below. All right, guys, take care of yourselves, take care of each other, and I will see you next time. Bye. I can't tell you.